Hello and welcome to the channel. In this video we'll be looking at a cylinder leak down tester. What is it? What does it do? How does it work? How to use it? And do you really need one? If that's something you're interested in, as usual, stick around and I'll get straight into it. Well, here we've got a cheap and nasty cylinder leak down tester. It's used in conjunction with an air compressor to supply compressed air to your engine cylinder, and then you can read off the percentage of leakage, giving you an indication of the health of the engine. Advantage of this over a compression tester is that yes, it will also tell you the health of the engine, but it can help in diagnosing where the faults are. When I recently did a compression test on Barney, the Barn Find bike, the compression was low at 145 psi, but the compression tester didn't give me an idea of what the fault was. We can use this leak down test to see the exact percentage of leakage and also where the leak is. Do we have warm piston rings, warm piston, warm cylinder, or is the leak from the inlet, exhaust valve, or cylinder head gasket? But there's nothing magical in how these testers work. In between the two gauges in the center there is a metering orifice, which is a fancy name for a very small hole, much the same as a jet in a carburetor. And so when this gauge reads, for example, 50 psi, it takes time for the air to get through the orifice there. So if we have a leak on this side, which is the leak to the engine, we can see the difference, the pressure difference, or delta P if you want to be really fancy, and we can work out how healthy our engine is. The first problem I had to swap this fitting there. The original one didn't fit on my airline. The original one had a Schrader valve in there. This one doesn't, and this is not the correct fitting in there, but it's all I had. See if I can make it work. And so the first thing we do is pull the knob off. So pull that out and wind it fully back. Wind it back. Connect the airline. Hope this is on camera. There is a slight lag, so wind up the regulator until the right gauge is on zero. And there we go. Let's connect it to the engine and see what happens. So I also had trouble screwing the adapter into the head. I had to use one of the brass adapters that came with my compression tester. So as I said, it's just been one of those days. If when you first put the gauge on, you hear heaps of air escaping either through the inlet or the exhaust, you know that you're not on the compression stroke. You know that the inlet and exhaust valves are not closed. So turn the engine over, double check the T mark, the top dead center mark, and get the engine sealed. Get the engine on top dead center on compression. Then you can look at your gauges. So as you can see, I've got the inspection caps off. Using the breaker bar, I've got the engine turned on to top dead center on the compression stroke. It can be really tricky to get it to balance there because the air pressure will want to spin the crank. So be careful with it. There's a lot of power in that and it can jump and hurt you. So maybe a good idea to have an extra person just to help. Well, as you can see, the gauge on the right is reading close to 40%. That's way too much leakage. You really would want way less than that. No engine is absolutely perfectly sealed. All engines will have some leakage, but close to 40%, way too much. And that's why our compression is down to 145 psi. The advantage of this leak down tester now over the compression tester is that we can fault find, see where the air is escaping from. And so listening into the exhaust, very slight, but almost nothing's coming through the exhaust. So they know that the exhaust valve is fine. and listening to the inlet. Nothing coming through there, so we know that the inlet valve seems fine. If we were unsure, we could just take the manifold off the cylinder head. But I think it's fine. As we're on this side, we can now hear a slight hissing coming from the inspection port there. So we've got air getting down into the crankcase. Could be a cylinder head coming down the, leaking down through the cam tunnel, the cam chain tunnel. I don't think so. There's a fair chance it's the piston, the rings and the cylinder. Take out the dipstick and you can hear it. You can even feel air coming out there. So Barney needs a rebore, piston, rings, something like that. When I rebuilt Barney, I used an old barrel, an old jug, whatever you want to call it, and piston, and an old cylinder head. A cylinder head that had problems previously with a leaking inlet valve. So I wasn't quite sure. That's why I used the compression tester to point me in the right direction. So hopefully you can hear that. What we'll do now, I want to make some changes to this compression tester. Let's just see if we can get a different result. Well, now what I've done, I've removed the percentage gauge and I've got two identical gauges. That way I can set the pressure at whatever pressure I wish. So slowly winding this up. I'm going to use 50 psi, I think that's a more reasonable pressure. And they should be the same, and they are virtually identical. I'll connect that to the engine and let's see the difference. With two identical gauges, they're both reading the same. Even with this wound up to 100 psi, this still reads 100 psi. I'm not really sure what's happening. The air, I can still hear the air hissing out of the crankcase there. Maybe I've outsmarted myself on this. Well, it's the next day now. I've had some time last night to look at the footage, have a think about what was going on. I believe the test was pretty much a failure. I'd just like to talk through what lessons I've learned. Well, firstly, we know that there's nothing worse than cheap tools. But unless it's your profession, unless you're using it every day or regularly to earn a living, it's hard to justify the expense of really high quality stuff. But in this case, this leak down tester, this was the cheap one, the generic one, and I think it's just no good. What I failed to notice yesterday, firstly, the need to set the gauge to 100 psi, that's crazy, it's way too high. And to try and hold the crankshaft on top dead center on these CT90, CT110s is really difficult. And if you use a breaker bar, as I did, if you're not careful, it can flick and you can break your arm or your wrist or somebody can get hurt. So being able to use 30, 40, 50 psi would be much safer. And you don't really need 100 psi anyway. First thing I had to do was change this barb fitting. And the original had a Schrader valve in the end. I didn't think that would make much difference. And what happened today, I've made up this barb and I've fitted a Schrader valve in the end. And it makes no difference whatsoever. As we wound up the gauges, these both went up in sync, exactly the same. Now that doesn't seem right. And also, I was really happy to see, well, I wasn't really happy, but when I saw the leakage, I failed to really take notice of this gauge. And what's happening, as this gauge drops, this one, they're both dropping at exactly the same rate. There's no pressure difference being recorded. So really, this tester is virtually useless. You can't rely on this gauge to give you a correct reading. It just doesn't work as it should. I've had a look inside, there is a small orifice in there, it's about there, machined into it. For some reason, maybe they've drilled the hole too big, it's just not working properly. Even with the Schrader valve in the barb there, still not working properly. What use is this tester? Well, in conjunction with a compression tester, if the compression tester gives a low reading, you can use this. Just simply set it at a low setting, ignore this gauge, and use the fittings to enable you to add compressed air into your cylinder and then fault find where the air is leaking from, as in my case, into the crankcase past the cylinder. It could be on the other side, there's a chance it could have been the cylinder head gasket leaking into the cam tunnel, but I don't think so. I think it's the rings, the piston. So overall, this cheap, nasty tester pretty much is a waste of money unless you're just going to use it as a means of supplying air, not to use this gauge. So a leak down tester can be a good addition to your toolkit, but buy a decent quality one. Don't buy one of these generic ones. I tried fitting an identical gauge, as you saw, and that simply rose and fell in sync. So there's no metering happening inside there. It's pretty much worthless. Well, thanks for watching. Thanks for your support. Thanks for all the subscribers. And I'll see you again soon in the next video. They are a bit of a fat... And listening rings the piston.